अस्सलाम वालेकुम फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू दिस मैटलैब ट्यूटोरियल। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू हाउ टू डिज़ाइन 200 वाट सोलर पीवी मॉड्यूल इन मैटलैब सिमुलिंक सॉफ्टवेयर। फॉर दिस पर्पज डबल क्लिक ऑन दिस सिमुलिंक आइकॉन टू ओपन इट। इन दिस विंडो क्लिक ऑन दिस आइकॉन टू ओपन अ न्यू मॉडल। First, we need to save it. You may save it with any name of your choice and in any folder. To design the 200 watt solar PV module, first we need the PV block. To get this, go to Simulink library and go to Simscape. Then click on power system. Then click on specialized technology. Then click on renewables, then click on solar. You can see here solar PV array block is available. Right click on this block and click on add block to the model. It will appear in the model. It may be noted that on the left side this PV array consists of two inputs, namely IR, which stands for irradiance, and T stands for temperature. Similarly, on the right side, it has positive and negative terminals to connect it with the other components. At the top, it has measurement port represented by symbol M. From this measurement port, you can measure the voltage, current, irradiance, temperature, and diode current respectively. Now double click on this PV array. A window will open, which contains the data of the PV array module. As this window represents very useful and important information about the PV module, therefore let us discuss about every point of this PV array. Friends, in the module section, this shows around 10,000 various standard models of the PV array which are available in the market by various companies. Therefore, if you want to use the real data of any company and its any model number, just select here that company and its model number. It will directly provide you all the specification of its power, voltage, current and various other values about that model. This is the great advantage provided by Simulink to implement the real PV array specifications in the Simulink. Now look at the model parameter section. Here it provides you the basic parameter values of the model, namely light generated current, diode saturation current, diode ideality factor, shunt resistance and series resistance respectively. Now look at another important section of this PV array. This section provides the current voltage and power voltage characteristics of the PV module at various temperatures and irradiance. To see the current voltage and power voltage characteristics of any model of PV array, just click on this plot button. It will show the maximum current and power at various voltage and temperature as shown here. As we want to design the 200 watt PV module, for this purpose, the module data section provides another feature to design the PV array module by user defined values. Therefore, click on this user defined option and insert the various parameter values. For this purpose, come to the data of the 200 watt table. You can see number of cells connected in parallel are 1 only. Therefore, come to model again and write here 1 as well as here 1. Look at the table again. It may be noted that open circuit voltage of the PV module is 32.9 volt. Therefore, come to model again and write here 32.9. Look at the table again. It may be noted that voltage at maximum power point is 26.4 volt. Therefore, come to model again and write here 26.4. Look at the table again. It may be noted that total number of cells connected in series is 54. Therefore, come to the model again and write here 54. Look at the table again. It may be noted that current at maximum power point and short circuit current are given as 7.58 ampere and 8.21 ampere respectively. Therefore, come to model again and write here 8.21 where is here 7.58. At this stage, we have successfully inserted the data for 200 watt solar PV module. Therefore, click on this apply button in order to apply these values to the system. You can see when apply button is clicked, the power rating of the PV module is automatically changed to 200 watt. This shows that we have correctly inserted the data. Now come to this current voltage and power voltage characteristics section to see its graph for 200 watt PV module. Select first option of one module at the 25 degree centigrade and specified irradiance. It may be noted that when you click this option, three different irradiance values such as 1000 watt per meter square, 500 watt per meter square and 100 watt per meter square are chosen by default. Let's click on this plot button to see its characteristics at these temperatures and 3 radians. You can see it has automatically drawn the graph of current voltage and power voltage characteristics. Similarly, you can try other two options in this section to observe the different characteristics of 200 watt PV module at different temperatures and irradiance. Friends, you may click on this help button to find the further detailed information about this PV module block as shown here. Now let's simulate this PV array for different input irradiance and temperature. For this purpose, go to Simulink library and bring the constant block from here in the model. Connect this constant block at the both inputs separately. As we want to get the maximum power of 200 watt, therefore double click on this block and write here irradiance value of 1000. Similarly, double click on this block and write here temperature of 25 degree centigrade to get the 200 watt of the output power. Now we need the power GUI block. Therefore, take the power GUI block from here and bring it in the model. To measure the voltage, current and power of this PV module, we have to complete the circuit and connect the resistance across it. Therefore, take the series RLC branch from here and bring it in the model. The resistance value for 200 watt, 26.4 volt and 7.58 ampere is 3.48 as calculated here. Therefore, double click on the series RLC branch. In the branch type, choose R only. And put here 3.48 ohms and press OK. Connect one terminal of the resistor with this positive terminal of the PV module. Now we need the ground block to connect it here. Therefore, take this ground block from here and bring it in the model. Connect this ground here. Similarly, copy this ground block and connect it with the negative terminal of the PV module to complete the circuit. Now we need the voltmeter and ammeter for the voltage and current measurements. For this purpose, take this ammeter and voltmeter from here and bring it in the model. Connect the ammeter in series with the circuit as shown here to measure the current. Whereas, connect the voltmeter in parallel with the circuit as shown here to measure the voltage. Now take the scope and display block from the Simulink library and bring it in the model. Connect the display as well as scope with the both voltmeter and ammeter to measure the voltage and current. At this stage, our model is completed. Now you can run the simulation. Change the simulation time to 2 seconds and click on the display button to run the simulation. You can see it has correctly measured the voltage and current values. Now compare the results with the rating of the 200 watt PV module. You can see both the results are correct. Now we need to measure the power of the PV module. As we know that power is the product of voltage and current, therefore take this product block from here and bring it in the model. Connect the output of the voltage and current with the two input terminals of the product block. Copy this display block, paste it here, and connect it with the product block. Similarly, copy this scope, paste it here, and connect it with the product block. Now run the simulation again to see the results. You can see it has correctly measured the power of the PV module, which is 200 watt. Now compare the results with the rating of the 200 watt PV module. You can see both the results are correct. You may also check the response of the voltage, current and power by using the scopes as shown here. Friends, it may be noted that PV module already provides you the measurement option as shown here. You just need to connect it with the bus selector block. Therefore, take this bus selector block from here and bring it in the model. Connect this bus selector block with this port of the PV module. Double click on this block. You can see it provides you the 5 measurements of voltage, current, diode current, irradiance and temperature. Click on this PV voltage and then click on select button. You can see it is included in the selected signals list. Bring the PV current measurement by repeating the same procedure. Now remove the first two signals and press OK. Copy this display block, paste it here, and connect it here to measure the voltage of the PV module. Repeat the same procedure to connect this display block here to measure the PV current. Now run the simulation again to see the results. You can see same results are obtained through this method. Therefore, it is now your choice which method you prefer. Repeat the procedure to measure the power of the PV module as shown here. Run the simulation again to see the results. You can see same results are obtained through this method. Therefore, it is now your choice which method you prefer for the measurement of voltage, current and power of the PV module. Friends, for your convenience, I have uploaded this solar model in the form of link in the description section of this video. For this purpose, go to the description section of this video. You can see the link is available here. You just need to copy this link from the description, paste it in the Google and press enter, or simply click on this link. This new window will be opened, which contains the solar model of this 200 watts PV module. Now click on this button to download this folder. Now click on Start Download. You can see it has downloaded the folder. Now click on Open Folder to see the location of this folder. Now right click on it and click on Cut and bring it in any drive or folder where you want to place it. Or create new folder, give it any name of your choice and paste it here. Now right click on this folder and click on Extract. You can see it has extracted the folder. Double click on this folder to open it. You can see it contains the PDF file as well as Simulink model of the 200 watt solar module. Now to open it in MATLAB software correctly, go to MATLAB software screen, go to E drive or where you have saved this folder in order to bring this folder in the MATLAB as shown here. You can see solar model folder is available here. Now double click on it. You can see Simulink model of 200 watt solar is available here. Double click on this model to open it in the Simulink. Wait for few seconds. You can see Simulink has opened this model correctly. Now you can run the simulation as discussed in this video. You can see it is working fine. That's all for today's tutorial. If you like it, then don't forget to like my video, subscribe my channel and share this with all your friends, so that they may also get benefit from this video. Thank you very much.